We must come to my garage and I'll show you something that'll knock your eyes out.
Frank Mitchell's treasure is hidden. Priceless art kept undercover for nearly 40 years.
He was only 17 when he did this.
An artist many believe has been forgotten by his country.
A talented, tormented expatriate, Leonard Mitchell was derided.
But never by his brother.
His work is unbelievably good.
This is Leonard Victor Mitchell, 90-year-old Frank's big brother.
He had to do painting and drawing every day of the week.
He had to.
He had to. It was like an addiction.
Between the 1940s and 50s, Leonard was one of our most successful painters. Portraits of famous Kiwis such as author Dame Nio Marsh and Prime Minister Walter Nash. And this.
Oh, wow. They're all life-size.
Yes.
1956 in one of his greatest works.
A
series of murals for the brand new Lower Hutt War Memorial Library. Every one of these portraits, painted by Leonard, is a real person.
That's not you, is it?
Could be you.
Their faces reflect a time of great optimism, a fresh start after the horrors of war.
Did you know that today's Len's birthday?
Yes.
He would have been 93 today.
He'd been 93. You're not forgotten, sir. You're not forgotten.
But by the end of the 50s, the classic style of Leonard Mitchell was being challenged by the modernists, the bearded hipsters of their day.
It's a filthy cancer of modern art, which is all genius but buggered all talent. And this was
there's a landscape of Leonard's at Te Papa. Painted in 1958, Stormlight and Snow, Ruahini Mountains is part of the National Collection, but it very rarely gets out of the storage racks.
The angry bearded modernists wouldn't have a bar of it, and yet nothing quite like this in New Zealand landscape painting had ever been painted before. I'd almost say this is a landscape that's on steroids.
The painting won our biggest art prize worth £500, about what you'd pay for a new car back then.
It meant a great deal.
But it wasn't enough, as the art establishment began to favour more contemporary artists.
He should have been born 50 years earlier, when the world was sane.
I think that was Leonard's tragedy. By living when he did, he came to be increasingly a sad and disaffected outsider.
Ignored by the galleries, left out of exhibitions, Leonard packed up his easel and headed to Europe. There would be no solace there.
He found antagonism and people blocking his way. The world that he thought was decent and honest was bloody horrible.
Painting still consumed him, and he produced a huge body of work from his home in the English countryside. But in 1980, at just 55, he had a huge heart attack and died.
He had so much stress towards the end of his life, and that's what killed him, stress.
Leonard died penniless, his artistic legacy piled up in the house he lived in. The forgotten art of one of our forgotten artists.
Come on, Matt, we'll show him a workshop.
Very few of them were ever seen in public.
There we are.
Wow.
They're out the back of Frank's place, in his workshop.
How many works are in here?
Hundreds. I mean hundreds. Everywhere you look, there are paintings, drawings, etchings. When he died, we shot across to England in 2.5 days and spent the next 3 months packing everything up. Paintings, 2,000 books, and brought them home in New Zealand, where they belong. I took a little sachet of New Zealand earth and put it in his coffin.
For almost 40 years, Leonard Mitchell's art has been out of sight, but never ever out of his brother's mind.
I do feel an enormous responsibility for what we've got left.
So Frank has gone back to work.
Do you ever sense Leonard when you're doing this? Or think about it?
Oh, yes, I do.
Framing up Leonard's paintings and drawings. The time is now right, he says, to show the public what he believes they have the right to see.
They've been denied paintings in this country of wonderful quality. New Zealand artists, New Zealand.
And this is Pat, his wife?
This is Pat, his wife, yes. My brother always looked to me to help him as best I could. I now have this legacy. Nobody see it safe.
So Frank and his daughter Anna are putting together a show of Leonard Mitchell's lost work.
I keep looking at this one here.
Yes. Because I think that's just so different. Yeah. It's almost Van Gogh.
Some they will never let go, but many will be for sale. That portrait of Dame Nio Marsh recently sold for $25,000.
Who is that drawing up there?
It's you, Papa.
Me? Oh, that doesn't look like me. Well, it must have been when I was yet very young and had hair on my head.
You still do, just you can't see it.
Oh, who do you think drew it?
Your brother.
Wasn't he clever?
Is it time we reassess Leonard Mitchell?
In a word, yes.
That's what Frank's hoping for.
I ask you to raise your glasses in a toast to Leonard.
It's absolutely wonderful. Just to see his paintings come back to life on the walls with these lightly sparkling, almost like nearly the day he painted.
Nearly half a century out of the public eye, a fresh light is now being shone on these hidden treasures. But time hasn't softened Frank's opinion of the modern art establishment.
I hope to God that they open their bloody eyes and wake up and all of a sudden say, oh Christ, the emperor doesn't have any clothes on, does he?